Hey everyone, I'm Jamie and welcome back to Teachers Tech. Imagine having an AI assistant that answers all your customers' questions 24/7, freeing up your time to focus on what you do best. What if I told you you could build one yourself in just a few minutes without writing a single line of code? Well, today, that's exactly what we're going to do. We'll dive into Microsoft Copilot 365 and build a basic AI agent from scratch. To make this fun, we'll be creating a customer service bot for my fictional doggy spa, Pooch Haven Spa. We'll train it using our own website and some documents. And stick around because this is just the first of two videos. In the next one, we'll explore advanced features in Microsoft Copilot Studio to make your bot even smarter. All right, the first thing you'll want to do is head over to Microsoft 365 Copilot and log in with your work or school account. Unfortunately, this won't work with your personal account. I'll put the link down below in the description. Once you're signed in, you'll land on the main dashboard. It's pretty clean. You'll see options to create agents right here, view existing ones, and more. Let's take a quick look around. You'll also notice that Copilot comes with some ready-to-use agents. For example, you might see a researcher that can analyze documents for you, or an analyst that can help you make sense of data and spreadsheets. These are fantastic for specific predefined tasks. But today, we want to create a completely custom experience, which is why we're going to build our own from scratch. Okay, let's get to the fun part, creating our agent for Pooch Haven Spa. Before we jump in, you might be wondering what the difference is between what we're doing today and the full Copilot Studio website. It's a great question. Think of it this way. The experience inside Microsoft 365 Copilot is the simple front door, perfect for quickly creating knowledge-based bots like we are today. The full copilotstudio.microsoft.com website is the advanced workshop in the back. That's where you add powerful automations, which we'll cover in part two video. So today, we're starting with a quick and easy way to get going. You're going to see a few different ways you can start building your agent. From up top here, create agent. If I scroll down, you'll see it here. I just tend to click over here and create them here. Now, it's pretty easy to get started, and we're just going to be using natural language to describe what we want. You can start with one of these templates here if we want, but as I said, we're going to start from scratch. So I'm going to go down right here, and all I'm going to say is a friendly AI assistant for Pooch Haven Spa customer inquiries. I'm just going to send this off. This doesn't take very long for it to get started. After a few seconds, it's all done the first part. It's saying that we have a friendly AI assistant for Pooch Haven Spa, but don't trust it yet because I haven't fed it any information, any knowledge base to know how to answer any questions asked. And the other thing right away I notice, I don't want this to be called new agent. In the original prompt over here, I could have told it to give a name to it, and it's even suggesting it down here. Now let's choose a name for your agent. It suggests the Pooch Haven Assistant. I have a different idea for it. I want to call it Pooch Pal. So just by doing this, it's going to go through and rename the agent. Now that we have the name out of the way, you can see that there's some refining that it needs to do. And we're going to go up to configure because the first thing I want to change is this icon right here. To me, that doesn't say Pooch Haven Spa very much. And notice this, I can change the name right here as well. If I go ahead and just change the edit here, notice I can upload a new icon. So if I go upload, I can go and I have one ready here. And I can go ahead and choose this. I'm just going to go all files and choose this and open it up. It does need to be under 1 megabyte. I'll apply this and you should see this right away get updated. Now, I used AI to create this image. I went over to create here and you'll see that you can create these images right inside M365 Copilot. And I just downloaded it and then uploaded it. Now, let's do some more configuring. You'll notice in the description section right here that this reflects this over here. So if you want to go and make a change to this, just go ahead and add something like maybe a support email or take something away and it will make the change over here. Let's move on to the instructions. Think of this section as the employee handbook for your AI. You're giving the core rules for how to behave, what tone to use, and what to do when it gets stuck. You can see Copilot has already made a good start based on our initial prompt, but we want to add a very important rule. I'm going to move down to the bottom and I'm going to go ahead and add this. Your tone should always be cheerful and professional. Most importantly, if you don't know the answer to a question from a provided document, do not make one up. Instead, politely direct to the email support team at the email. Now, let's move to the brains of the operation, the knowledge. And this is where we add links or files. If you go ahead and just click in here, you can see right through here all the things that you can add. So these could be through your OneDrive connected. We have different things from Word files. We have our Microsoft Teams or SharePoints through here that we can add for the knowledge base. We can also add just a website. So if I go ahead and add my website, I can go ahead and hit enter. And you'll notice this is going to be part of the knowledge base. We can even add files. So I can drag and drop them over here, or I can hit upload from device. And let's grab these two. These are frequently asked questions and a little bit more information on our services and pricing. So if I hit open, you'll see this becomes part of our knowledge base that they're going to answer the questions from when they get asked. I want to point out with anything that you upload, if any changes happen to the document, you'll need to upload new ones. If it's going to be a website, the website's fine. If something gets updated in the website, it will be able to pull that new information. Let's move down to capabilities now. If you want your agent to do even more, you can go ahead and toggle these on. So with a code interpreter, if you needed to add something that needed to calculate, you could turn this on. If you needed your agent to create images, you could go ahead and turn this on. For myself with Pooch Pal, I don't see the need for either of these, so I'm just going to leave them off. Our last item that we can change are the suggested prompts. These right through here, notice they'll show up here. And you can go ahead and delete any of these or even add a suggested prompt. This will allow your users to kind of know what to ask. Sometimes you go to something and you're not sure to where even start, but this will give you some ideas what they can ask. So down here though, they can go ahead and type their message. So let's ask it something basic. When are you open? Let's see if it knows. This should be from the knowledge base that our time should be there, and it should be able to search the files to find the answer. And there you go. In a very friendly way, thanks for asking. Pooch Haven Spa is open during the following hours, 8 to 6, Saturday, Sunday. If you're planning a visit, it's a great idea to book an appointment. So a very nice communication, and it didn't take any time from you once you have this set up. Now, let's try something it shouldn't know. Let's go ahead and ask this. Who and how old are the owners of Pooch Haven Spa? Now, look at the response. Thanks for your question about the owners and their ages of Pooch Haven. They've searched through it. They haven't found anything. And remember, in the instructions, I told them to email this, to give this email so the person could reach out further. So it gives you an idea of how those instructions directly worked. Now, with everything configured, and we've tested it here with a few prompts, let's go ahead and publish this. We're going to go up top and click Create. It's creating the agent now, and you'll see at this point when it pops up, currently only I'll have access to it. As you can see right here, the link only works for you, but I can go ahead and change the sharing the settings. Do we want anyone in your organization, specific users in your organization, or only you? So if I was switching it to everyone in the organization, then they can have access to this. I can go ahead and hit save. And what I want to point out to is this over here. This becomes one of the agents. So I'm going to go ahead and close this. If I go to all agents now, I have Pooch Pal right here on the list. And if I go ahead and click on it, I'm in Pooch Pal now. I'm going to go ahead and ask it one more question. How much is the Spa Deluxe package? We'll send that away. And there's the information that it pulled from the documents that I gave it. So there you have it. In just a few minutes, we've built a custom AI agent that's ready for internal use in your organization. But what about putting it on your public website or teaching it to automate tasks like sending emails? That's where the full power of Microsoft Copilot Studio comes in. And it's exactly what we'll cover in part two. You won't want to miss it. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to Teachers Tech for more. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time in the next video.